Welcome to the video news of the week. A tragic accident occurred shortly after 5 p.m. on Tuesday in Colebrook, which claimed the life of two local men. Stewartstown residents Jason Howe, 87, and his nephew Waldo Hicks, 62, both died when the pickup that Howe was driving veered out of its northbound lane and hit a snowmobile trailer in a southbound vehicle, and then ended up hitting another southbound vehicle head-on. The crash, which occurred near the state rest area, closed that stretch of highway for 2 hours, with traffic being routed through the rest area access. Both men were declared dead at the scene. The driver of the other vehicle involved in the head-on collision, Michelle Rodrigue of Hudson, initially refused treatment, but later was taken to Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital by private vehicle with a leg injury. Waldo Hicks was a well-known local figure who worked for LaPerle's IGA in Colebrook since 1978 and had just left work having been picked up by his uncle and was northbound when the crash took place. Police are looking into what the cause may have been that led the Howe vehicle to suddenly leave its lane with the accident resulting. Road conditions and other influences do not appear to have been a factor. Since Tuesday's tragic deaths, there has been an outpouring of grief and condolences all throughout the region. Waldo Hicks was a congenial fellow who was a veteran bag boy at LaPerle's IGA and was beloved by all who knew him. His uncle was dedicated to helping Waldo through life as he drove Waldo to work and back again, as Waldo did not have his own driver's license. In a companion story this week, we remember the two men, especially Waldo, whose sudden death sent a shock through the region. We remember Waldo and the fun he had each Halloween, dressing up and coming to work as a familiar Where's Waldo character. In his early days, when he and his Uncle Jason were hit at the JC's Winter Carnival, as shown here in our photo taken of the two performing back in 1980 at the popular talent show. On Sunday, a community service remembering Waldo Hicks will be held at the church he attended for many years, the Independent Baptist Church in West Stewartstown, beginning at 1:30 p.m. The public is invited to come and share their memories. The 45th Parallel EMS Ambulance Service is searching for a new chief executive officer to replace Rob Darling, who stepped down effective today. Darling had been with the ambulance service for several years. His resignation was accepted by the board of directors at a special meeting held on December 30th. Jim Conley, who is the chairman of the 45th Parallel EMS Board, told the Chronicle that under Darling's direction, the 45th Parallel EMS made great strides. The board is presently reviewing a number of applications, and they hope to be able to name a replacement within the next 2 to 3 months.
On January 4th at around 10 a.m., Francesca Gadwa, 24, of Columbia, was southbound in a 1988 Oldsmobile Royale when she slid off the road near Talmadge Plumbing and Heating in Stewartstown. There was no report of injury, and the vehicle was drivable once back on the road. Responding to the scene was Beecher Falls Volunteer Fire Department and the 45th Parallel EMS.
This past weekend, our Canadian correspondent Corey Bellum visited the Sawyerville Skating Rink to check out the action. He saw rink master Jeff Cross busy shoveling snow over the boards, and the rink was filled with children of all ages skating around. The rink is a popular location during the winter in Sawyerville, and a big hit with children who are home during Christmas break. The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at LaPerleIGA.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather brings lasting snow into the weekend with a high of 23 degrees. Saturday drops to a high of 12 and a low of 4, and Sunday brings a high of 20 with a low of 14. The team from Littleton traveled to Pittsburgh to play the Pittsburg-Canaan Yellow Jackets in varsity basketball this week. Watching the video news of the week.